Hello and good day. In this particular PowerPoint presentation, we are going to look into the who are liable for registration under the GST, as well as we are going to discuss on the voluntary registration. But before we go into the detail, let us understand few terminology which will be necessary subsequently to understand in detail. The first one, permanent account number or the PAN number. The PAN number is a way of identifying the various taxpayer in the country, and this 10 PAN number is given by the Income Tax Department. It consists of the 10 digit unique identification alphanumeric characters, and it is given to the Indians, mostly those who are the taxpayer in this particular country, India. And around 25 crores PAN number are already issued out of the total population of 125 plus. Then the next term is a supplier. The supplier in relation to goods or service means a person who is supplying the goods or service or the both, and it also includes the agent who are acting on behalf of someone, and that someone is known as a principal. Then taxable supply means the supply of the goods or the service or the both which are liable to tax, and the tax rate has been prescribed, which varies from 0% to 28% plus the cess. The non-taxable supply means the supply of the goods or service which are not leviable to tax under this act or under the IGST. These are the crude oil, then alcohol and electricity. These are the non-taxable supply. And the last one more terminology is a principal. Principal means a person on whose behalf the agent carries out the business. So agent and the principal. Agent is compulsory required to register himself. The principal will be coming under this particular registration. Now let us look into the value, because here at certain places registration is required when the value exceed the particular amount. So here it says the value means aggregated turnover. So value of all the goods, whether it is a taxable supply, whether it is an exempted supply, whether it is your export, or whether it is your interstate supply, all this value has to be added. And if this value, after minusing the tax on that, or any value of the supply of the taxable value which is chargeable under the reverse charge, that means when we have to determine the value, basically we have to look onto the credit side or the revenue side of the financial statement. It may also include the sale of any asset, but we don't have to look anything on the expense side. So that value on the revenue side, including the sale of a fixed asset, that has to be total up, and in that value, if the tax is included, that has to be minus. And whose value? A person having the same permanent account number across all over India, transactions will be considered. So even if you are having a turnover, say 10 lakhs in Maharashtra, 5 lakhs in Delhi, and 5 lakhs you are exporting the goods, another 5 lakhs are the goods which is exempted from the tax, then all these 25 lakhs will be considered for registration in Mumbai or in Maharashtra, in Delhi or any other place. In total turnover has to be considered, and then it has, that will be treated as an aggregated value. So below given charges has to be excluded while calculating this aggregated turnover. First, a tax with respect to CGST, SGST or IGST. The taxes element has to be minus. The value of the tax payable on the reverse charge mechanism, that also has to be deducted. Value of any inward supply of the goods or services, that also has to be not taken into consideration. That means if there is a sale return, the sale return has to be deducted, and then net aggregated value has to be considered. Or value of any non-taxable goods like alcohol, petrol, or sale of land, or building, that has not to be considered when we are determining the liability. Then one more thing. In the case of the small taxable person with the aggregate turnover up to rupees 40 lakhs, now as per the amendment from 1st January 2020, even the interest on deposits and the loan and advances which he may receive, that should also be not considered for determining the liability position. Then in case of the job worker, like example plating industry. Now in the plating industry, a person, someone else provide the material. On that material, the plating is being done. The question arises whether that value of the material also should be included or not. So here it has been very clearly provided that the material value will be included in the value in the principal's case. But the job worker who is doing the job working, that means who is doing a plating, whatever the charges is charging only for plating, that only has to be considered when determining the liability of the job worker and not the value of the goods which his customer is providing. Then let us come to the registration under section 22. Any person who is already registered under the earlier law need not have to apply for the fresh registration. They will be automatically migrated under the GST from the various VAT, service tax or excise duty, and they have to only select an option whether they want to continue or not. That means if the turnover is below the limit, they may decide not to continue depending on the SWOC analysis which has to be done. Now there are specific circumstances when a person has to apply for the registration. The first one is a case when a business is being transferred from one person to another person, either by sale or by succession, whatever the account may be. In that case, the transferee or the successor has to obtain a new GST registration number. Or if there is an amalgamation of the company, or if there is a demerger of the company, in that case also, the new company has to obtain the GST registration number. Then a person crossing the threshold limit also has to apply for registration. This we are going to deal in the next slide. And at the end, any person can always take a voluntary registration under section 25, subsection 3 of the GST Act. Now the GST has provided the various limits. And for this particular purpose, they have divided the state into two parts, a special category state and other than the special category state. So in special category state, the limit is of a lesser amount. And other than the special category state, the limit is of the higher amount. So if your aggregate turnover is crossing 20 lakhs rupees, then registration is compulsory. However, from 1st April 2019, if the turnover is crossing 40 lakhs, then registration is compulsory. But in certain cases or certain businesses, still that 20 lakhs limit is applicable. And that certain business where still 20 lakhs limit is applicable are the ice cream and the other edible ices, or pan masala and tobacco and the manufacturing the tobacco related products. For this, the limit is 20 lakhs, but for others, it is 40 lakhs. That means if you are trading in the pan masala, or if you are trading in the tobacco, or if you are trading in the ice cream, then the limit is 20 lakhs. But for all other goods, the limit of compulsory registration is 40 lakhs. In the special category, the same limit of 20 lakhs is 10 lakhs. That is in the state of Manipur, Mizorama, Nagaland and Tripura. In these four places, the limit is 10 lakhs. In the state of Jammu, Kashmir, Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Himachal Pradesh, Meghalaya, Sikkim, and Uttarakhand, from 1st February 2019, this limit has become 20 lakhs. So, if you are crossing the provided limit in a provided state, then you have to compulsorily go for a registration. Once liable for registration, the following procedure has to be carried out as per Section 25. First thing, you have to apply within the 30 days from the date of the liability. However, in case of a casual taxable person and non-resident taxable person, you have to apply 5 days in advance. Then you are required to submit the PAN number, mobile number, email ID, and now Aadhaar card also is a compulsory. However, if you are a non-resident person, then you have to submit the passport detail. On submitting the above preliminary information, the government will give you TRN number, that is a temporary reference number. And on basis of the temporary reference number, you have to submit all other detail, like all other detail of the transaction, the nature of your business activity, the date from when you started the activity, the detail of the goods and service you are dealing with, and all this information is required to be submitted online. Once the information is submitted online, the officer will verify. And if he find any deficiency or he required any clarification, he will issue the memo, and that memo need to be attended in a given due time period which has been prescribed in that notification, in that memo. And once that is cleared, within the 7 days, the government issue the registration. And if the application is made in time, the registration is effective from the date on which your liability was being crossing the date. And if it is a voluntary, from the date you have applied for. And if you don't apply within the 30 days, the registration is effective from the date of application. Once the registration is done, it is valid up to the cancellation. However, in case of the casual taxable person, the registration is valid only up to 90 days from the date of issue, which can be further extended for the another 90 days. If you require any amendment in the certificate, then one has to file the amendment application online, and this has to be made any change in the detail of the registration certificate. Now all other aspects of registrations are dealt separately. That is with regard to compulsory registration under Section 24, person not liable for registration under Section 23 are discussed separately. Kindly go through the statutory note. The effect of registration also we have dealt separately. And the practical guidance of registration has been discussed separately, and it is not a part of this particular series of discussion. Thank you.